Hey guys, so this is DT Gaming. So we're gonna be working on this model here. So this would be a Bream. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna start back here around the tail. I normally like listening to music while I'm actually working, so I hope you guys really don't mind. It's nothing that's bad, but it's just basic peaceful stuff. It? Where is it? Where is it? Did I place this in here? Hey, Ruby. Did you find where the fish? I can't find the damn thing. So unorganized, unreal. Groove music, maybe? Recent plays. I'm disgusted. I can't find what the heck I was using. I ain't gonna worry about it, screw it. Maybe other people wouldn't like music to listen to. It's supposed to be copyright free, but I can't find it. I don't think I deleted it, so. What? I'll be right back, guys. I gotta do something quick. I'm being called. Yeah, I did. Okay. Actually, I'm not going to do that. I was going to put that overlay thing on, but I just changed my mind. We might actually change the do a like a speed type video later. Also, got my webcam on either this time because I don't want to hide anything down here just in case if people want to see or want to like maybe follow along or something. That volume that loud. I am going to look around online for a reference of this fish. But I want to see what it looks like from the top view of it because. I want to know how wide the fish is actually is. Meant to readjust the these here. I can accommodate that I after. This right here. Center. Here. Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna build the eye after. Okay, now you know that it's don't look right. It's too it's too fat. You see? Yeah, it don't look like a fish. It looks like I don't know what, but I'm gonna fix that right now. That's why I need to look for a reference. For this right here. So I need to see what the top view of the bream actually looks like. I can see it's got some wide shoulders up here. So, to fix that, FD box here. Allow me to shape this out better. Actually, I'm gonna put 8x8. What the hell's that? Hold on, guys, I got a phone call. Freaking spam caller. That should be actually usable in that way. Well, I do a quick save. Now, the mouth on this fish is kind of like a suction cup. So what we're going to do collapse this. This is why I saved this, because this might not work the way I want it to. But we're going to give it a go anyways. So right here, you can see where the mouth is. Then down here. Then I gotta make a cut from here. This way I actually support the lips. Can't barely see the white line, so I'm gonna make it a little darker. I'm gonna put a symmetry on. And I'm going to, down here. Okay, so these new lines right here, I want to make a cut going across. And I kind of actually want to cut from here. So what I'm going to do, this new line I created here, I'm actually going to remove. We're just going to use that main line right there for the lip. Then all I have to do is select these. Before we do that though, we're going to collapse. So we're gonna make cuts up here. Okay, I'm gonna sing Betrayus one more time. Flaps. Actually, fine. I don't need to collapse it yet. Until I start forming the lips and stuff, then I have to collapse it then. See how I select this vertice here? That one's over here automatically selected. All right, now I can see where the mouth is at. What the hell's here? Oh, hold on, guys, I got something here. Someone's here. Okay. Grab these and pull this in. Okay. Now I'll start doing the gill. Save this real quick. Now you see where the gill plate it goes like right underneath the like that. Where I cut from here. Actually, so that's it will work. I'm gonna have to do something down here when I get that far. Gonna do a quick save again. I'm gonna take these vertices, I'm gonna weld them. Including that one. Yeah, I thought something was gonna work here. So what I need to do, I need to take this vertice down here. I need to drag this down. Oh, I gotta turn that off. Okay. Ah, shoot. God dang it. Why did I lose to? I make sure I actually got that shut off. Gotta make sure there's enough of gap over here. That's gotta be open. Well, not that much. Right, now I should let me do what I want to do with this. Going on over here? This is why I did that separate save, because sometimes these things work, sometimes they don't. This one I don't know about. I mean, it might, but I won't know until I add the smooth modifier on, which I'm gonna do that right now. It looked like it's gonna work okay. There is something going on right here. That line it needed. This line it needed. Nope, something is not working here. I think it's something to do with this part over here. There, a step back, a few steps here. He slept that. Well, this. Now it should be okay now. there's something right there that's gonna be pulled down. That should work, actually. This inside lines are critical to get right. And I think down here what messed up the last one. That's why I unselected those. See this one here, I want to match the same way as the top part. Now I can actually fix this part and pull that out where it belongs. There we go, that's better. All right, so next thing we do is just add the color to it. And then we'll start working the lips. All right, guys, give me a few minutes. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. Well, I was actually here. I was actually just eating breakfast here. Just don't want to eat on you guys' ears here. I can't do color yet. I was looking at something. I forgot to do the eye socket. I'm gonna work on that right now. So we're gonna grab this vertice right here in the center, and we're going to chamfer that like so. Then we want to create a connecting edges here, from here, the center on each side. And we got to actually delete that symmetry. Can't use this setup. I mean, I'm about to do. And so I put the polygon just created. I'm gonna click spherify to actually make that a complete circle. Collapse it down. Now add a symmetry modifier. Of course, that means I got to come down here and turn that edge, that cage off again. And I'm gonna actually go ahead and delete that polygon. So now we're gonna shape this out. So this will actually fit the eyeball. So, question to you guys, if you guys are in Noble Fish and stuff, why does the Bream look like it has such a droopy eye? So I'm gonna take this border here, and I'm gonna actually pull this down like so. And that, pull that in like that. And I create a loop here. Out. Then these vertices I'm gonna pull up. So, well, then the vertices back here. So that pretty much creates the eyeball, actually. Get Let's see what this looks like. So it's almost perfectly cylinders, circled here. Now I'm gonna grab a spear. Actually, drag a spear right here. Yeah, lower that segments down to about 12 here to top view. Check that out like so. Now, a fish's eye is actually angled like this. But I'm gonna leave it the way it is. I think what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna try to work on this part right here. A bit more of an shape that will work with this eye. I think that will work. Yeah. All right, so the next thing to do is add the color to this to the model. Now, excuse me. Well, of course, we gotta turn on our renderer. They want to merge some type of lighting into the scene. Actually, change the color of that. This light I want to pull up. Which way that is facing. So I'm going to add a camera here. So the light's right there. The light is facing the right side. I'm going to pull that over here. Place the light behind the camera. What? Ah, hold on, guys. But they want money. Well, since you got a watch, you're going to get that malware and you're going to lose your hero. I tried it off before she got into it. She had a locker, you peered up, then she would have called the people to get her computer unlocked. Exactly. Last time she did, had that before, it cost her $300 to fix it. All right, sorry about that. So I want to remove that before I do anything. I got to basically move that out of there. Take all these right here. Shit, I should have muted the mic. I just heard myself talk on there about that. Sorry about that, guys. It's all this stuff is flat, otherwise this ain't gonna work. Wait, that's the wrong one. I need the texture, not that. Shoot. How did I forget to do that? Damn, what the hell? Texture, where are you? This cannot be there. I don't want the fin baked onto the model. Okay, there we go. Let me look at something here. If that's actually correct. Because when I looked at this, and then I looked at this right here. Oh, just realized something. Oops, damn it, don't want that. Right, to see what that looks like. I That was falling into place pretty good on its own. Now, there might be some stretching right here, but it should fix itself once I start adding the fins. Okay, so this looks like. Might not be no stretching. I mean, it's a little bit, but like I said, when I add that fin, that ain't gonna be there no more. Let's add a bit of color to the eye now. No, seeing the eye is supposed to be fully reflective. Gonna change a couple things on that. Eye is so weird on a brain. Is that right there being fixed? Because as a reflective on the eye itself, which I don't want. See right there? Yeah, that. I'm gonna get rid of that. Now, do we just update the map? All right, let's do the first render to see what it looks like. Now, we still need to do the mouth. Oh, I pushed a button. Oh, wrong button. I think it looks pretty good. All right, let's do a quick save and now we'll do the lip. Okay, so what we're do with this mouth here? I'm gonna actually grab that. And we want to we here actually grab the UV unwrap one more time. Actually, I kind of want to unselect some stuff here. I do want the whole thing in there. Yeah, actually, I do. Okay. Kind of grab that. I don't know how they actually get through. I mean, I actually banned them myself. But they still broke through. Okay, something went wrong there. Going on there. Well, actually, I know what's going on with. This ain't connected to anything. Okay, so I can't select that. I just need to, okay, that should fix that problem. Now I'm gonna do this again. This is why I didn't want to do the inside part. And now I can actually work on this. Jeez, dog, you snore so loud. All right, I hope this works. Hey, dog, snoring so loud. I think this actually turned out pretty good. The lips look what's look like it's supposed to look. Supposed what they look like. The eyes, the gills, everything looks okay. The next thing I want to add is a side fin. So seeing we don't have that on no more, but we're still waiting to actually make this transparent, which is refract. We got the fin right here, so I actually want to make a cut right to here. I'm gonna create a what you call it in here. Another loop in here because this fin's gonna be difficult the way it's shaped. I'll try this. I ain't gonna work either. I'm gonna do the way I usually create the fins. This is where I'm going to create it from right here. So it's kind of look like it's going to be out of place, but it will turn out. This should be fine. Do it that. Oh, never mind. It just looks like that. Definitely out of place, but how I could do this the way I can, because the way this thing is shaped. How do I got that fin look? Okay, I just have to try and see if it'll work. Don't. I can just undo it. So. Save that real quick. What I do to bed, not fly it. I bet it didn't fly it. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. The fin is shaped differently. Actually, maybe it is gonna work out. Okay, what the hell's going on there? Stretching going on, that's why. That'll work. Oh, that guy worse. I don't know what to do. That's a whole problem right there. I gotta unsuck that. Hey, fishing, how you doing? Hey, that should fix this. Least I hope. I said, I think that knew that it was going to be hard to do this one because of the fact is the way this damn thing is shaped. Okay, that should be fine. Looks better. What is going on here? There's a gap that I don't like. I bet that this has to be on here too, on this displays. Yeah, that looked like was the problem. I have to have that displace on there. Otherwise, gonna have that like that tear right there. Actually, I'm not going to place that line there. Benzo. All right, I'm gonna save here real quick. All right, guys, give me a few minutes. I'll be right back. All right. So next thing we want to work on is a spin down here. What we're going to do, seeing the spin is actually kind of tucked in the bottom. It's kind of like the same as this pin right here, but it's kind of like tucked right underneath it. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the exact same texture from this one and put that down here as this pin. So how we're going to create this is kind of similar to the same way we did that. We're going to come over here. We're going to do an inset. Like this. I want to squeeze this down. Like that. It kind of looks funny how the fin and the eyeball is floating around. Because I hit the model so I could see what's going on. But I don't need to hide it now. Because fix the local so I can do it this way. Okay. Let's start extruding. But don't like that. I'm gonna thin this down. The way this fin is, it's hard to get the proper shape. Oh, hey. Give me that pod that's in the fridge, eh? The blue one that's on the shelf, thank you. On the shelf, the only blue one that's in there. I just gotta do some things here. I don't think I have to close that. I think that'd be probably the way it is. We want to take this and roll. What do you want, me? There you go. Dog wanted food. Alright, let's see if this bin's gonna turn out. I hope it does. I don't see any other way of making this. Should have saved it before I did this, but so I can always step back if I have to. Did you eat? I'm gonna drag that to here. I mean, this should actually fit pretty good because it's almost the same shape. Okay. Like I said, it's so hard to get to spin the way it is. It don't look right, but that's how the fin looks because it's tucked in. Trying to correct it though. I don't remember closing that. If this don't work, I might have to erase that line right there. That edge. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to do it that way. I'm gonna take this edge right there. There's something going on right there. There's gotta be a bleed. Yep, there's a bleed right here. There we go. Symmetry that, no, not that. Symmetry that. Flaps. Plane. We are done symmetry the model now. So now all the rest are, is just one fin. So the one up down here, the one up here, and the tail, we're done.
Wait.
You want another one? Kind of concerned. Of that right there. Because this worked out, but there is something going on right there. I don't like it. Fact is that line there. So what I'm gonna do, try to see if I can do it this way. Maybe that will solve the problem. All right, try that. I mean, it's not as bad. There's like a shadow here, like they left it off. I don't know why. I ain't gonna worry about it. I think it'd be fine. I'm just gonna do this. Put this down to 1.2. The same with this side, 1.2. That might fix it. And it did not. I was just gonna work on the rest of the model now. I'm not gonna worry about the where the hell that little thing is. It should be there, but it's there. Maybe there's a something to do with the texture. I'm just double checking if that's the case. Alright, so now we just work on the top and the bottom fin next. This would be fairly simple. Well, we're gonna take this plane and we gotta pull this back to the side leader. Now I gotta figure out where the heck this is up here. There. Need a new edge loop right here. So grab from here to here and up here. I want to grab from this edge to that edge. And I want to chamfer that. Like that. I'm gonna grab these polygons up here. Then we'll come up here, here, have another one. Did I go too far with this? Yeah, I did. Grab one too many lines. I want to use that line up.
here.
He's such a beggar. Okay. Now, this is important, and I have to add this part. Hopefully, this does not cause a problem, but shouldn't, because I didn't take those two fins outside the line. I don't got any more. All right, Leo. You act like you're depressed. What damn does that? So I'm gonna right click on it and then don't right click properly. Okay, so that did not work out. I need to do something with that. There's some lot of stretching. I think this is why. So let me fix this. This guy go up to here. Now that looks right. Before I actually close that off, want that on. This alpha here is not fully black. No, it's not. Oh, boy, boy. Okay. That's what was going on. Why it wasn't looking right. There, see how that it looks, like supposedly transparent. With that render. So something I did not like about this, so I'm fixing it. So I'm actually going to put these inside where it should have been. Because if you notice that the fin itself don't look like it's got like weird shapes to it, so okay, that looks better. The way that is, that just like that. So let's do a quick save. Now we're gonna do the bottom fin here. Now this fin right here has like a weird shape in here. It don't look like I added it though. You can see I tried, but it didn't work. But again, I gotta figure out where this meets here, so I need to grab this edge. Create a loop here. That's fine. And luckily, this actually goes right to here, so I need to just grab that pin, that edge, and this edge. That edge right there, this edge, I'll grab all the rest in between. I'm gonna come up here. Wanna make sure that line. The red line actually matches this side here. Well, actually, technically, I don't want to do that with that because over here it's kind of pushing into each other. I don't want that, so just thin that down some. Thanks for the sub there, XNTV. Much appreciated. Now I just grab these newly created polygons here. Just do a slight extrude. Scale that down to about right there so it matches that. Extrude. Then I want to make this transparent again. This top part, I wanted to squeeze down just a little bit more. Might need to put another edge in here. Yeah, that fin is done. I'm actually not going to worry about trying to animate in this. I'll let the customers take care of that. Mm-hmm. Dang, just grab it. All right. The hell happened there? I did something I didn't. This is bad. I slept something on the opposite side and I shouldn't have. Yep, there's a problem right there. It's a simple fix, actually. Okay. That problem got averted pretty fast. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is the back part. This part right here. About 3 hours in. There with that backside selected. And now these lines right here, I'm gonna actually make some cutting here. This I'm actually gonna collapse. This is gonna be welded. I should be actually, you know what? I actually want to cut this back to there. Okay, that's done. Now we just gotta do drag these into place. Now I just take all that. Now this will actually fall into place easily. So what we're gonna do, pull that out a little bit. We're gonna grab these vertices here and basically line them up as close as possible so we don't have no seams up here showing, but still keeping it separate from each other. Case if I need to edit or something. Try to keep these vertices as close as possible to the other side. That way, look from afar. You really don't notice any seams. Now, the next thing to do just unstuck those and extrude. Aaron. Line right here. All right, that we have to make more skinnier. Like that. And grab all these edges here and do a connect. We'll add about two segments. This create a tight edge right here. Don't think I have to do that to your side though, that's fine. Alright, let's see what it looks like. Oh wait, I didn't add the texture yet. Tail. Yeah, it looks like I didn't even I guess it don't need the alpha map. I did these fins in a way that I don't need it. Yeah, I'm gonna remove that alpha fin. I mean that the alpha on here because I'm not even using it. But yeah, the model is done, guys. I'm gonna make that tail bigger, though. It looks too tiny. I mean, too small. I mean, but how I'm gonna do that? I'm gonna actually grab polygons there. I just gotta pull this out some. So. Now, because of doing this, this kind of I gotta work. Maybe the tail is supposed to be that small. And again, I can just do it this way. There we go. Well, What the hell happened there? Did I move the model? But I did by accident. Well, anyways, I gotta actually do the other eyeball here. Near this. Actually, not yet. Back to pivot. Center. Anyway, guys, that concludes the model actually. Anyway, if you guys like the video, make sure you hit the like button. You guys can subscribe as well. I appreciate the support. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time. Until then, guys, bye.